just friends. I want to get closer to you, baby. Hey, closer than just friends. How about you? How about you? It's hard to explain. When you're close to me, I get a warm sensation inside. I can't deny this, I want to try it each and every time you come by. Girl, I don't wanna lose your love by putting my cards on the table. You know I'm thankful for what we have, but I have feelings inside, they're so strong I can't hide. Get closer to you, baby. I want to get closer than just friends. Get closer to you, baby. Get closer than just friends. How about you?
I know you're probably thinking that you heard this so many times before. Girl, when you're here, I want you to stay.
Hard since he went away and left you so sad. Thank you very much, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Once more, you're welcome to the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Today's event is very significant in the history of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. We'll be celebrating our 38th Founders Day, 38 years of committed contribution to academic excellence, research breakthroughs in all ramifications, and also the graduation of our latest graduates. Based on the latest 4ICU ranking and other notable ranking bodies, Federal University of Technology, MENA graduates are always ranked in the top 10. And for us to see you going out to the labor markets, we know that in no distant years, we'll occupy first position. The investiture ceremony of the University Chancellor Designate His Imperial Majesty Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Aladelusi, the Deji and paramount ruler of Akure. In order to avoid stampede, we won't allow dignitaries to stand behind the pavilion. Please, if you cannot secure a seat, there's another canopy designated for parents of graduates. Please, those standing behind, please get a seat. If you cannot get a seat, please, there's a designated canopy for graduates, parents, and well-wishers. Please, thank you very much. Let's ensure strict compliance. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we also have the representative of the Executive Secretary, National Universities Commission, here with us this morning, and the person of Dr. N. Saliu is the Director of Academic Planning, NUC. You're welcome, sir.
Transmitting live from our outside broadcast venue.
FlyPower.ng recording studio is the official recording studio of Search 92.3 and Search TV.
Search TV.
Located at MBB House, FUT MENA, main campus, Kidankwano. FlyPower.ng recording studios is your destination for your audio and video work, as it is highly equipped with digital, modern, and traditional instruments. So for your audio and video jingle productions, poetry or spoken word, music recording sessions, song mixing and mastering, podcast recording and production, production, radio and TV recordings and production, audiobooks recording and production, speech recordings, independent program production on radio, TV or social media. Also equipped has a live performance studio and live radio recordings for solo artists or groups, as well as brand rehearsal sessions. We have a range of in-house sound producers to work with you, and you have the option of coming with your own desired producer for your recording sessions. All here at the MyPower.ng Recording Studios, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. MyPower.ng Recording Studio, MBB House, opening soon.
I'd also like to recognize one of the board members of the Hydroelectric Power Producing Areas Development Commission and the person of Mala Isa Ozi Salami, OFR. You're welcome, sir. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the 38th Founders Day and 30th Convocation Ceremonies procession has taken off from the Academic Publishing Center. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this is the last moment of grace to all graduates and other invited guests. Please, you are all expected to come into the arena. Please come inside the arena. The military band, please, over to you, please. The convocation procession is made up of the following categories. We have the academic procession, the graduate procession, the alumni procession, the congregation procession to be led by the Deputy Registrar Establishment, Mr. Eli Gbadafu, the Senate procession to be led by the Deputy Registrar Academic Office, Mrs. ASD Usman, the Council procession, the Chancellor procession. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please, you are all expected inside the arena. Please, we don't want people to stand at the back of the pavilion. Please, if you cannot get a seat, please, you can go under the canopy. There is a dedicated canopy for parents, friends, and well-wishers of the graduates and other guests of the university. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, any moment from now, we'll commence this very important occasion happening in the month of February. All graduates, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, very soon, you will all be expected to rise and to remain standing. Please, let's get a seat and settle down. As soon as the procession enters, we don't want any roaming around. You are all expected to stand and remain standing, please. Want to specially recognize other members of the University Senate that are seated already. I can see the immediate past dean, School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology, our very own Professor A.J. Odofi. On a very special note, we would like to recognize the presence of Alhaji Modi Adamu Aliu. You're welcome, sir. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I want to most respectfully recognize the presence of Royal Fathers from the South. Okay. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we have Royal Fathers from the Ondo State Council of Obas. It's a very significant event across the Niger. If you refer to this event as an handshake across the Niger, you won't be wrong, judging by the retinue of Royal Fathers that we have here today to grace this very important occasion. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Your Royal Highnesses, you're welcome to Federal University of Technology, MENA, the best specialized university in Nigeria, a university that is known. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please stand up, please, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and remain standing, please. At the appropriate time, you'll be told on what to do. Leading the graduate procession to this very magnificent arena is the Deputy Registrar, Student Affairs Division, of our very own Mr. Zacchaeus Kolo. Leading the graduate procession, behind me are the latest graduates of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Immediately after the graduate procession, we have the graduates that will be receiving special awards this morning for academic excellence in their various departments and schools. Leading the alumni procession is the Alumni Relations Officer, the Principal Assistant Registrar, our very own Mrs. R. Bello.
Yes, and of course, we are right here at the Suleiman Nkomo Convocation Square. The procession from the Senate is just making their way into the Convocation Square, and we have the Nigerian Army Band right here giving the music. Of course, I'm here with Mary Blessing. I'm here with Mary Blessing, Felicia, and of course, we will be joined from time to time by Mr. Oni Kayode Phillips. It is almost time for the convocation ceremony to start officially. As soon as these officials, as soon as the principal officers of the university are seated, we will get into the 30th convocation and 38th Founders Day ceremonies officially. Mary Blessing, what do you have to say about what we are seeing right now?
Right now, we are having the moving from the Senate building to the Convocation Square, and they are moving in a certain order. As you know, that organization is key in FUT MENA. We have the first degrees holders in School of Agriculture and Agricultural Technology. We have School of Electrical Engineering and Technology, School of Environmental Technology, School of Information and Communication Technology, School of Infrastructure Process Engineering and Technology, School of Innovative Technology, School of Life Sciences, School of Physical Sciences, School of Science and Technology Education. The academic procession is moving from the Senate building to the Convocation Square, and we're having a fanfare by the Nigeria Army Band, giving them a sound, and with the members of the assembly standing. So the procession will enter the Convocation Square. What I have just given now is the rundown of those in the first degree. There will also be graduates' processions following immediately after, having the deputy registrar and the graduates. Then we have the alumni. The alumni will be the alumni relations officer and the alumni members. Then we'll have a congregation procession. That will be the deputy registrar, members of congregation who are not members of Senate or Council. Immediately after that, there will be the Senate procession. That will be the deputy registrar academic, the members of Senate who are not professors or members of Council. Then we'll have professors who are not deans or directors. And then we have directors, then we have Dean of Schools and Student Affairs, then we have the Dean Postgraduate School. Immediately after that, or following after that, we'll be having the Council procession, which will be the Deputy Registrar for Council Matters, the registrars of other universities, visiting Vice Chancellors, visiting Pro Chancellors, former Vice Chancellors of FUT MENA, who are road. And then we'll be having University Librarian, University Bosser, members of Council, the Deputy Vice Chancellors. And then finally, we will be having the Chancellor's procession, which will be the University Mace Biera, the Registrar, the Vice Chancellor, the Pro Chancellor, the Executive Secretary, National Universities Commission, the Visiting State Governors, the Chancellor, and a visitor. And as soon as the visitor is in front of his seat at the Diet, the National Anthem will commence immediately, followed by the FUT MENA Anthem.
And as you can see, that this whole thing is really organized. Taking a look at the procession, it's a very colorful procession to look at. We can see all of the principal officers in all their colors and making their way to the Suleiman.
Yes, it's been a pleasure to be here. I've been privileged to be a part of the commentary team for a number of convocation ceremonies now in FUT MENA, and today's event happens to be a very special one because this marks the first time that such media will be broadcasting live pictures as well as audio from the commentary position. In the past, we've had to describe to a T the colors on the ground, what the graduates are putting on, what the VIPs are wearing, and all of that. So this year, I think it's kind of special because as we are running the commentary, our audience can actually get to see for themselves the pictures. The mood is right, the ambience is perfect. We have sonorous tunes from the military band from Traddock Command, MENA, in the background, and everything is just perfect. And in a matter of minutes, we get to start the convocation proper.
But of course, not in ceremony for the undergraduates. We will get to the Chancellor, His Imperial Majesty, Oba Alade Turimbo Ogunlade Alade Lucy. And following the installation of the Chancellor, we will move on to the convocation ceremony proper, where there will be investiture of first degrees for graduating students of this very prestigious university, Federal University of Technology, Minna.
It is also worthy to note that there are different colors of that are being worn, and you can see from red and purple to white and purple, and the purple always stands out as it signifies royalty, it signifies what FUT is really made of. And today they're not just going to be awarding certificate as FUT prides itself in character first and then in learning, and we are currently seeing the procession coming in so that we can officially start the convocation ceremony.
If you are on our search team, you can see a cross-section of the principal officers who have made their way right here to the convocation square. We are just waiting for the main principal officers to be. The convocation ceremony will start off properly. Of course, you can catch everything the same way that we have been bringing your way since the beginning of all the events that have been lined up for the 30th convocation ceremony and the 38th Founders Day right here at the Federal University of Technology. Of course, all you have to do is move to any of our social media pages on Facebook, Instagram, and you will be able to follow all these events live. I remember that after this main convocation ceremony, there will be a commissioning of events during the course of today. And of course, tomorrow, there will be the honorary degrees that will be conferred on very prominent members of our very great nation, Nigeria. Of course, in just a few minutes, the convocation ceremony will begin properly, and you can expect to get all the details right here on the Dial of Champions Search FM. And of course, on Search Media, talking about the TV. If you're paying attention, you can hear the very beautiful music that is being given by the Nigerian Army Band. They are here giving the place a very beautiful ambience, also with the university colors flying all over the place. I must say that we must commend the security agencies, from the police to the civil defense, to the university man o'war services. We have to say that they're doing a very, very good job. The convocation square seems to be full right now. We have parents and well-wishers who have come here to wish their friends, their family, their children who are convoking today. Of course, you can hear the silence. We are just about to begin the convocation ceremony proper. And that is the Nigerian national anthem to kick off the ceremony.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the university anthem of the best specialized university in Nigeria, the most cosmopolitan university of Nigeria, the university anthem of the Federal University of Technology, MENA.
A citadel of learning, technological advancement of the land is your primary goal. To build a self-reliant force of sound mind and moral, who will make our nation relevant in global development. You take me now, we lift your flag up high. The pride of Nigeria you are, and you will ever be our love for you.
Thank you very much, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated.
This is a live broadcast transmission of Search FM 92.3.
And that was the...
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen,
followed by
it is with utmost delight
that
I especially welcome you to the 38th Founders Day and 30th Convocation Ceremony of the Great Citadel of Learning. For us in FUT MENA, we are not first among equals, we are the first.
Founders Day.
At this point in time, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the visitor of the university, ably represented by the Honorable Minister of State for Education. With your permission, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, permit me the honor of inviting the registrar of this great citadel of learning and the person of Mr. Amos Madu Kolo, Chartered Personnel Institute of Management, to take us through proceedings of this very important 38th Founders Day and 30th Convocation Ceremony of the best specialized university in Nigeria. The registrar, sir.
And
distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we also like to inform you that this event is being televised live on the University Search TV, and it's also being broadcast live on the University Campus Radio, Search FM 92.3, and other social media platforms. The registrar, sir.
And of course, the registrar is just about to step up to the podium to give the call to order and give the order of
now
events for this ceremony.
The Chief Imam of the University for the opening prayer.
And the Chief Imam of the University will be coming to give the opening prayer for the convocation ceremony. Of course, it's very important to start every event with a prayer.
Min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. We give thanks to Allah, Allah that has mentioned in Quran that wafaddala Allahu al-mujahideen ala al-qa'ideen darajatan. We also give praise, peace to our dear Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who has mentioned talab al-ilm farida ala kulli muslimin wa musliman. We pray to Almighty Allah that whatever program we are going to do today, may Allah let it be a successful one. And we pray to all our graduates, may Allah be with them and be with our management and be with Nigeria and our dear state in general. Bisir al-Fatiha. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين آمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
And a very big amen to that prayer. Of course, here is the registrar of the university.
I now invite the chaplain of the university for the opening prayer.
The chaplain of the university is now going to sit. He's going to offer the Christian prayer.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, we want to thank you for giving us this great privilege to acknowledge your faithfulness over our students, through the efforts of all our lecturers, both academic and non-academic staff members, the management, and all that you have used in being blessings to them. Father, we thank you for this great privilege. We desired it last year, but you didn't allow it. Thank you for allowing it this year. We are confident that by the reason of your purpose for all these students, you are raising them up to be means for great changes that we are trusting you for in Nigeria. Thank you, Almighty Father. We commit everything we'll be doing to your care, and we ask, O God, that you will show your power in every way, you will secure all of us, and your name alone be glorified. Thank you, Everlasting Father. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
We say a big amen to the prayer that has just been offered by the chaplain of the university.
The Federal University of Technology, MENA, Act No. 13 of 1986 empowers the university to grant degrees, diplomas, certificates, and other distinctions to persons who have pursued a course of study approved by the university and have satisfied such other requirements as the university may lay down. The university can also grant honorary degrees, fellowships, or academic titles. Article 5, Section 8 of the Talk Schedule of the Federal University of Technology, MENA Statute, states that, subject to Section 4 of the Act, the Chancellor shall be chairman of all meetings of convocation when he is present, and in his absence, the Vice Chancellor shall be the chairman at the meeting. I therefore have the honor to invite the Vice Chancellor to declare the convocation open on behalf of the Chancellor.
And just now, the Vice Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, Professor Abdullahi Bala, has been invited to declare the convocation ceremony open. He's ready to make the declaration just about
I now. Declare this assembly open as a convocation of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, constituted for the purpose of award of honorary degree, admission to first degrees, and award of prizes.
And there you have it. We can officially say now, because the number one person on the campus has said that this convocation ceremony is officially open.
Vice Chancellor, sir, the Federal University of Technology, MENA, on the recommendation of Senate and with approval of Council, has found His Imperial Majesty Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Adelusi Odundutu Deji and paramount ruler of Akure Kingdom worthy to be conferred with the honorary degree of Doctor of Technology, honoris causa of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. I therefore call on the university orator to present the honorary graduate.
All right, we will be witnessing the award of honorary degree to the Chancellor, His Imperial Majesty Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Aladelusi. He is the Odundu II Deji and paramount ruler of Akure Kingdom. We will see that he is ready to receive his award.
Respectively, may I with due respect invite the Deji of Akure to kindly be on his feet. Thank you. The Vice Chancellor, sir, I present to you His Imperial Majesty Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Adelusi Odundu II, the Deji and paramount ruler of Akure Kingdom, Chairman of the State Traditional Council of Obas and Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, as a worthy recipient for recognition and befitting honor. It may interest this distinguished assembly to know that the Odundu plant, Calancho crineta, is associated with calmness, coolness, and dignity, usually planted in front of the shrine of Ogun, the Yoruba god of war, metals, creativity, and surgical arts. William Shakespeare, in his play Richard III, wrote, "The king's name is a tower of strength, that is, strong, tall, and unassailable." This graphically captures the men of Oba Alade Toyibo, Ogunlade Adelusi, or Dundo II, the highly intelligent, humble, calm, and charismatic Deji Ofakure, as he sits confidently on the royal throne as the 47th paramount ruler of Akure Kingdom. From today, he will preside over this august ceremony as the fourth chancellor of this great university. The Deji was born as Patrick Bankole Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Aladelusi on December 28, 1956, into the legendary family of Oba Odundun Aladelusi, the only son of Oba Adeshore Osupa. The third of 10 children, Oba Alade Toyinbo obtained quality education at St. Patrick Roman Catholic Mission, Akpomu, for his primary education, and the prestigious Oyemekun Grammar School, Akure, from 1969 to 1973, where he received the secondary school certificate, His search for knowledge took him outside the shores of Nigeria to Florida International University in Miami, Florida, between 1977 and 1981. Where he bagged a bachelor's degree in architecture and then crowned his formal education pursuit with a master's degree from Morgan State University in Baltimore, Maryland, USA. He came back to Nigeria to observe the mandatory one-year National Youth Service Corps in the service of his fatherland, 1984 to 1985. He also worked briefly as a lecturer at the Premier University of Ibadan, 1984 to 1986. His Imperial Majesty consulted for many companies and organizations to ensure compliance with materials, design, and specification safety in construction works. He was also involved in organizing clients and team meetings for the famous Alpha Corporation Incorporated in Baltimore, Maryland, USA, among several others. Shortly after his return to Nigeria, he was appointed as a special assistant to the Ondo State Governor and attached to the Ministry of Planning and Finance between 2007 and 2009. After he successfully completed his tenure, Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Adelusi Odundun II established three construction companies: Top Notch Global Ventures Limited, First Interlink Global Resources Limited, and Decowab Limited, which were all engaged in road and landscape construction. His Imperial Majesty, who is not only one of the founding members of Architects Registration Council of Nigeria, but also a prominent member of the Nigerian Institute of Architects. He has given several public lectures in higher institutions like Obafemi Awolowo University and Adekunle Ajase University regarding the role of youth in governance. Amongst indigenous of Akure, who were also heirs to the throne, the gentle and amiable Oba Alade Toyinbo was unanimously chosen from the Osupa royal family of Akure and proclaimed Deji of Akure in 2015. True to his title, Odundun II, his reign has been described as an epoch of peace, and he serves as the spiritual leader of his people with the responsibility of making supplications to God and the Orisha on behalf of his clan and the world at large during annual festivals such as Ogun and Odefunta Festival. His Imperial Majesty was destined to be king. He was strong. He has strong ties to royalty across boundaries as a distant relative of the royal house of Benin through his fifth great-grandfather, Oba Akenbuda, a king of the Benin Empire, and thus a sixth cousin of Oba Eware II, the current Oba of Benin. He is a direct male line great-grandson of Oba Odundun I, great-great-grandson of Oba Osupa I, and a third great-grandson of Oba Arakale. His great-grandfather's first cousin was Oba Adeshida I. The Deji of Akure is also related to the Elemo chieftaincy title holders for two centuries, the notable Adedipe family of Akure, and thus a second cousin of Chief Olufalai. As Deji and paramount ruler of the kingdom of Akure, His Imperial Majesty is involved in peace advocacy, not only in Ondo State, but also in the Southwest and Nigeria as a whole. According to Martin Luther King, who said, "We must live together as brothers or perish together as fools." Ododo II is a man known to be passionate about his people. The Deji is a worthy recipient of an appreciation letter from the government of Ondo State for curtailing crime through communal efforts. The successful strategy he utilized has become a model for many monarchs within the state. Oba Aladeto Yimbo is a patron to many organizations such as Elan Club Akure, Oyemekun International Club Baltimore, Nigeria Union of Journalists, Ondo State Akure Inner Circle, Oye Development Initiative, among others. He is a recipient of many national and international awards and recognitions. His Imperial Majesty is a devout Christian and a dedicated member of St. David's Anglican Church, Cathedral Akure. Often, Queen is a pillar of strength to the King. Deji is married to exceptionally brilliant, humble, and accomplished Oloris, and enjoys watching American football, traveling, meeting people, and listening to news. Indeed, Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, the federal government selected an admirable first-class Oba to serve as the Chancellor of this great citadel of learning. The Council and the Senate of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, are committed to giving honor to whom honor is due, especially His Imperial Majesty, who is a man of peace and a bridge builder par excellence. It is therefore the unanimous decision of the Council and Senate of this great institution to confer on His Imperial Majesty Oba Aladetoyinbo Ogunlade Aladelusi Odundun II, the Deji of Akure Kingdom, with the degree of Doctor of Technology Honoris Causa, Federal University of Technology, MENA. It is therefore my singular honor and privilege to invite you, sir, to confer the degree on His Imperial Majesty.
And that was Professor J.O. Oyero given the autobiography of the soon-to-be-conferred Chancellor of the University in the person of Oba Aladetoyinbo Ogunlade Aladelusi. And of course, we have the Nigerian Army Band playing a fanfare as this conferment is about to be taking place. In a few moments, we will have the Odundun II, Deji and Paramount Ruler of Akure Kingdom, as the official Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. And a sea of purple surrounds him as they are investing the colors, the university colors of purple, on his royal persona. And very soon we will have him speak to this gathering of very great academic minds and graduating students.
By the powers conferred on me as the Vice Chancellor, in the name of Senate and Council, I confer on you the honorary degree of Doctor of Technology Honoris Causa of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
And he has been conferred with the honorary degree by the Vice Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, the honorary degree of Doctor of Technology Honoris Causa of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. And up next will be the official installation of the Chancellor.
And that is a fanfare from the Nigerian Army Band celebrating the Chancellor of this university. He has just been conferred with an honorary degree of Doctor of Technology, DTech, honoris causa. And just like Odaba has said, we will be coming up next with the installation.
Our laws provide the Chancellor shall preside over all meetings of the convocation held for the conferring of degrees, diplomas, and higher degree certificates. Therefore, in order to properly constitute the convocation, it is my honor to request the Vice Chancellor to invite the visitor for the formal installation of the Chancellor.
And that is the registrar officially inviting the Vice Chancellor to invite the visitor for his formal installation as the Chancellor of this university. Being the Chancellor, he will be presiding over all meetings.
I hereby call on the Chancellor designate to kindly proceed to the dais for the installation. It is my honor to invite the visitor to perform the installation of the Chancellor. Visitor, sir.
The Vice Chancellor has just invited the visitor to perform the installation as the Chancellor of this university. And just as I was saying,
His Imperial Majesty, Oba Aleto Alade Toyibo, Ogunlade Alade Lucy, Odudun II, Deji, and Paramount Ruler of Akure Kingdom, will you pledge that throughout your tenure of office, you will uphold and preserve jointly and severally the statutes and laws of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, completely, faithfully, without favor, as much as it lies within you?
I pledge that throughout my tenure of office, I will uphold and preserve jointly and severally the status and law of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, completely, faithfully, without favor, as much as it lies within me. I further promise to perform faithfully all the functions of the Chancellor, the highest office of the university.
In accordance with the powers conferred on me, Chukwue Mekan Wajuba, representing the visitor of this today's university, President Muhammadu Buhari, President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the visitor to the Federal University of Technology, MENA, I formally install you as Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MENA.
And that was the visitor, Chukwue Mekan Wajuba, representing the President Muhammadu Buhari. He is the Minister of State for Education.
I hereby invite the visitor, assisted by the Vice Chancellor, to robe the new Chancellor in the appropriate regalia.
And now the visitor and the Vice Chancellor will be robing our prestigious Chancellor, and thereby installing him as the Chancellor of this university. And he has just been robed. So he is officially the Chancellor of Federal University of Technology, MENA.
Of course, this doesn't seem to be a new process for the Oba, seeing as he has been installed as an Oba before now. So he would be used to all of the ceremony and all the rituals that involve being installed into office, either as an Oba, and in this case, the Chancellor of the very prestigious Federal University of Technology. I mean, of course, following the installation of the Chancellor, we expect a convocation address by the newly installed Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology. Of course, he will be invited shortly. If you are listening to us right here on the Dial of Champions, Search FM 92.3, remember that you...
I now respectfully call on the Vice Chancellor to hand over the convocation to the Chancellor. Vice Chancellor, sir.
This is a live transmission broadcast of Search 92.3.
Hand over the convocation to the Chancellor.
And following the ritual, the Vice Chancellor has invited the newly installed Chancellor. Well, there's a lot of ritual here, but eventually the Chancellor will come to the dais and he will deliver
Chancellor, sir,
the convocation address.
This assembly, having been duly constituted as a convocation of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, for the purpose of conferment of degrees and for the presentation of special prizes, I now respectfully call upon you to deliver your address. Chancellor, sir.
And finally, we have the Chancellor making his way to the dais to the very beautiful sound of fanfare by the Nigerian Army Band. He will deliver his address shortly.
I specially recognize the visitor, ably represented by Honorable Minister of State of Education. I also recognize the Executive Governor of Niger State, who is ably represented by his commissioners here. I recognize the governor of my own state, Arakunrin Akeredolu, SAN. The deputy supposed to be here is on his way, who is representing him. The chairman of council, pro-chancellor, Professor Olu Obafemi, I recognize you, sir. Our own Vice Chancellor, you are recognized. My own Baba Shifalai, CFR, former SHG, you are very, very welcome, sir. His Royal Majesty Oba Olufemlayo Omoniyi, the Archbishop of Ipecha, you are welcomed. All visiting chancellors, deans of faculties, you are all welcome. I welcome.
Transmitting live from our outside broadcast venue, this is Search FM.
I welcome Senior Chief Henry Shola Adegomire, you are welcome. High Chief Henry Gwenga Deye, you are welcome. I have a list of long protocols here because all my people were been parading our airport since Saturday. The weather was so bad, and upon all that, they are all here with me today. So I have to recognize them. Chief Olatubos Mila, you are welcome. Chief Adeni Ibalogun, you are welcome. Chief Titus Yerugule, the Ashaju of Igbo in Akure Kingdom, you are welcome. Chief Babangida Saki, the Seriki of Hausa community in Akure, you are welcome. Of course, my Oloris, who are here with me, because when I heard that my house can only accommodate 5, so I don't want to bring all of them. So. My son is here too, Prince Kola Aladetoyinbo. My chief of staff. Distinguished guests of these great universities. Our own exceptionally brilliant graduates. You're all welcome. Gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. It is a great honor to welcome you all to this historic occasion, the 30th Founders Day and the 30th convocation ceremony of our great institution. Today's celebration is special in that it is my first convocation as chancellor of this world-class university, known for academic brilliance around the world. The occasion of this Institutional Founders Day provides us with an opportunity to reflect all that we have accomplished as a university over the past 38 years, as well as to make projections for the years ahead in order to advance the socio-economic and technological development of our country in accordance with our visions and mission. Indeed, This is a historic occasion for us. So let us bring out the drums and sound our trumpets in honor of the significant achievement we have made so far. First and foremost, I want to specially thank President Muhammad Buhari, GCFR, who is also the visitor of this university, for considering me worthy of this national appointment. The appointment exemplified President Buhari's unwavering commitment to national unity and cohesiveness. I want to assure you, Mr. President, that I will carry out my obligations as Chancellor for this university diligently and in accordance with the institutional regulation governing the Chancellor's power. This appointment means a lot to me and the good people of Ondo State, as well as the entire Southwest region. I pledge to promote harmony and cordial relationship among the university's many ethnic groups so that we can work together to realize this lovely goal set forth by the institutional founders. My president, please accept my heartfelt gratitude. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I would like to take this opportunity to pay a glory tribute to the university founding fathers whose ambition and dreams paved the way for its foundation. These trees they planted a few years ago have sprouted and flowered with various branches. Thank you to all of the previous vice chancellors of this university for everything you did for the university throughout your stewardship. Let me add that as a specialist university of technology, we must continue to think outside the box to ensure that we fulfill the purpose of the federal government's establishment of this university by conducting cutting-edge research aimed at solving our current societal problem and accelerating economic growth. Since more funding is required for the university to achieve its stated vision and mission, I am appealing to the federal government to establish a special fund for specialized universities in the country through the Tertiary Education Trust Fund, so that this specialized university can champion the country's technological drive in line with federal government digital economy initiatives. Let me express my gratitude to the University Governing Council and management for their cordial working relationship since the appointment by the federal government. This kind of collaboration is critical for the university to fulfill its institutional goals while also maintaining its enviable status as a specialized university. As a result, I urge the council and management to continue to collaborate cooperatively for the university's benefit. To the graduates, I join your parents, friends, and well-wishers in congratulating you on your graduation from this illustrious institution. As a new graduate, you are able to go out your own incredible life journey and create your own adventures. I implore you to confront the challenges ahead with calm and confidence. You will make it if you have a focus. The certificate you will get today is a license to go forth and change the world for better. With the converted food mina certificate in your hands, the sky is the limit. I wish you the best of luck in all your future endeavors. I would like to applaud the University Vice Chancellor, Professor Abdullahi Bala, for building on the foundation he inherited and went ahead to transform the university narrative since assuming office in 2017. The commissioning of 23 high-quality projects that within four years. By failure dignitaries during this convocation is a testimonial to your dedication to ensuring that Food Mina maintain its enviable position among Nigerians and the world's universities. I know that there is some mirage of challenges bedeviling us, which are not peculiar to our dear institution. More pronounced among these is the issue of befitting hostel for our students. Let me assure you that I shall make frantic effort with the management to solve this critical challenge. I shall make concerted effort in this regard so that we can achieve this within the shortest time possible. If the Chancellor can do a project of 23 in 4 years, I think I should be able to build a hostel in 1 year. Let me assure you that I will give all support it requires to the management to ensure that we encourage excellence among our students so that they can compete favorably in the labor market, which has become the survivor of the fittest. I know you all fit, you are all going to make it. In pursuit of this mission, I shall consult with the management to institute an award for the best overall graduating student of this institution, as well as the best student in architecture, which is my own discipline. I want to assure you that you will always have my fatherly concern and support in ensuring that the university fulfills its institutional mandates. To all the invited guests, thank you for honoring our invitation, and I wish you all a safe trip back to your various destinations. May God bless you all. Thank you all. Long live the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Long live the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you, and God bless.
From the Suleiman Kumo Convocation Square, main campus of FUT MINA, this is the outside broadcast of Surge 92.3.
Chancellor, sir, I have the honor to call upon the Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of the Governing Council, Federal University of Technology, MINA, Professor Olu Obafemi, NNOM, to deliver his address to the convocation. Pro-Chancellor, sir.
And following the convocation address by the Chancellor, we will have an address by the Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of the University Council.
Live from the Suleiman Kumo Convocation Square, main campus FUT, MINA, this
Federal University of Technology, MINA, by my humble self. The visitor and president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Your Excellency Muhammadu Buhari GCFR, ably represented by Minister of State, who also was the one who saw me in as Pro-Chancellor. Your Excellency, the Governor of Niger State, Alhaji Abubakar Sani Bello, the Honorable Minister of Education, in your own right, members of the National Assembly, members of the Federal Executive Council, members of the Niger State House of Assembly, members of Niger State Executive Council, the Executive Secretary ably represented by the Director, Dr. Salim, the Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MINA, His Royal Highness Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Alade Lucy Oduno II, the 47th and current DG of Akure Kingdom, and His Honoris, who he could only bring two out of them. The Royal Highness, my colleagues, members of the Governing Council, Federal University of Technology, MINA, the Vice Chancellor and Management of Federal University of Technology, MINA, former Vice Chancellors here present, registrars, visiting Vice Chancellors and registrars here present, members of Senate and the entire staff of Federal University of Technology, MINA, parents and guardians, and these most worthy graduates of this great university, my own invited guests, beginning with my fairer half, my wife, Mrs. Grace Obafemi, Your Royal Highness, the Oba of my kingdom, His Royal Highness Oba Jem Kiri, the Olukiri of Kiri Kingdom, ably represented by his deputy, the Oba Dauphin of Kiri Kingdom, Ogui. My other guests, including Chief Ade Daniel, the foremost estate manager in this country. Ladies and gentlemen, this auspicious day is the first since my appointment as the 8th substantive pro-chancellor and the chairman of the Governing Council of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. It is thus with immense pleasure that I welcome and address this highly distinguished audience at the 38th Founders Day and 30th convocation ceremony of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, which is Nigeria's specialized university of coveted choice. Permit me to take this opportunity to formally condole with the families, friends, and the university over the death of my predecessor, the immediate past pro-chancellor and chairman of council of this university, Professor Femi Odekunle of blessed memory. Professor Femi Odekunle was an age-long personal friend and a brother. His death came as a shock to me personally and to all of us in this university. But because he lived such a fulfilled life, we must all find comfort and solace in the amazing legacies he left behind and pray for the peaceful repose of his precious soul and life. May the Almighty God grant him eternal rest. Let me also condole with the family and the university of the passing of one of his very dynamic vice chancellors, the late Professor Daniel. May I humbly request this audience, since this is our first formal occasion, to rise to give condolence for these great souls. May their gentle and illustrious souls rest in perfect peace. Let me, at this juncture, congratulate our new chancellor, I believe the latest in town, His Imperial Majesty Oba Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Alade Lucy Odundo II, the Deji and Paramount Ruler of Akure Kingdom, and Chairman of the Traditional Council of Ondo State, on his investiture by the visitor as the Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, today. The Governing Council is greatly delighted with your appointment, and I assure you on their behalf of our unqualified cooperation and total support. Well, you have begun to hit the ground running, that by this next year we will have a hostel. I think it deserves a round of applause. I will be at your neck to ensure that this is fulfilled. Based on my interaction with the university management and staff and students, and in particular, the unions, I consider myself fortunate to have been assigned to a university that is peaceful, loving, progressive, and secure. As a result, I'm highly thrilled to join the university's management, staff, and students in congratulating all our graduates and their families on the successful completion of their study from this great university. And you, the newest graduates of this university, graduation is the ultimate desire and anticipation of all university students, their parents, and their teachers. The journey that began a few years ago with varying degrees of anxiety for many of you, if not most, and the academic rigors that followed must have been very exacting, even oftentimes very stressful. However, with focus and gritty determination, you braved the odds, and today you have been celebrated. I therefore salute and congratulate you all for turning out to be very worthy recipients of the coveted degrees you have earned and which will soon be conferred on you. I also congratulate your parents and graduates on this day of joy as they reap the fruits of their labor. As you receive your various classes of degrees indicating your academic attainment, I ask you all to consider these academic achievements as merely the takeoff point of your journey through life. There is still a lot to be done, and there are several chances in and outside the shores of Nigeria that need innovative thinking and entrepreneurial spirit for you to attain lofty heights in life. This university, in my opinion, has prepared you to tackle the difficulties that you may encounter in life. Please, do not let us down, and do not let yourself down. Because, as we know, and from feedback, that our past graduates are highly sought after by employers of labor. I must, in particular, commend the graduates who will be receiving prizes for distinguishing themselves in their studies. And I urge the others who are not winning prizes here today to note that they still have many opportunities to distinguish themselves in their chosen endeavors in life. As I said, the first degree is a start-off point. As you leave this university and embark on various life's exploits, always remember to conduct yourself as worthy ambassadors of Nigeria's choice specialized university, the University of Minna. The university has high expectations that you should stand out and shine radiantly wherever you go. Be worthy ambassadors of this great citadel of special learning. In this regard, I urge you to keep in mind that the twin problems of indiscipline and corruption, which both obstruct progress and national development, are the primary causes of the socioeconomic challenges that have resulted in high youth unemployment in our country. It is, therefore, imperative for me to admonish you all to resist all temptations of manifesting indiscipline, moral turpitude, and indulgence in corrupt practices in the interest of your generation and the good of your fatherland now and the future. Mr. Visitor, sir, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, at this juncture, I would like to emphasize unequivocally that this governing council under my leadership is delighted to be associated with this university. It has a national and international staff and student body, since it has always been a place where all Nigerians and non-Nigerians feel at ease. Because it is calm, it is serene, and secure. We are therefore grateful to President Muhammadu Buhari and the Honorable Minister of Education for not only appointing us in the first place, but also for sending us to this particular university. The university's excellent qualities are a source of pride and esteem. In line with the Governing Council's desire to promote staff and students' welfare, I am happy to report that the Governing Council, at its meeting that held in November 2021, considered and approved the massive, almost unprecedented cases of promotion for both teaching and non-teaching staff for the years 2020 and 2021, respectively. And we look forward to doing more. Council is abreast of the massive infrastructural needs of the university and the desire for specialized funding for a specialized university. Here I chorus the chancellor, so that it will enable advancement in teaching, research, and community service. We will pursue these critical needs with all the vigor at our disposal. There is a general appeal for improved funding in tertiary institutions in this country. This university is not exempt from this appeal. As you know, our university has a large land, but it is porous. It is open to vandalization. It is open to encroachment. The chancellor just spoke about the need for hostel accommodation. There is also need for staff accommodation because our staff are national and international. They need to be here. We need to build a campus culture. Thus, while our university makes this appeal, especially in the area of capital appropriation, while recording our unalloyed appreciation of the critical import of TED Fund in this university and for research and support for education for academic work, you can find that a lot of what we are commissioning are from TED Fund. I urge government to further give priority to funding education as the bedrock of national development in this fourth industrial revolution built on knowledge and knowledge production. This university, under our watch, will also continue to improve on its revenue generation drive, as we also call on corporate bodies and well-endowed individuals to come to our support. There are many rich Nigerians. They should redirect their fund, their money, to education and to universities. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I must express my gratitude to the host communities of MENA and its environs for their cooperation and kindness. I'm grateful to His Excellency Governor Abubakar Sani Bello, previous leaders of our country, General Ibrahim Badamasi Babangida, GCFR, and General Absalam Abubakar, GCFR. It is very rare to find two former presidents in one town. May I urge my governing council colleagues to continue in their zestful focus on and support of the appeal to keep the mission that we have set for ourselves to focus on development. I also want to emphasize the importance of maintaining the university's integrity, accountability, and due process. I congratulate the university's administration, Senate, and staff on their dedication to accountability. I would like to express my gratitude to the staff and the great student unions in ensuring the smooth cooperation operation of the institution and the tranquil atmosphere that prevail on our campuses as we continue to pay attention to their genuine needs and aspirations. Finally, and very significantly, I want to express my gratitude to the Vice Chancellor, Professor Abdullahi Bala, for leading a dedicated management to the university. From the short-term period that we have been here, I have found your genuine commitment to moving the university forward with the collaboration of council to achieve focused vision and progress of the university. During these convocation ceremonies, and it's a testimony of the hard work of the Vice Chancellor and Management and Council, 23 high-quality projects will be commissioned. Some already commissioned yesterday. These projects include 3 schools with all the departments fully built and equipped. This is an attestation of the Vice Chancellor's dedication to excellence in running the university. Let me therefore assure you, Mr. Vice Chancellor, that the Governing Council, led by myself, will not rest on its oars until we have completed our task of building a university that we all shall be very proud of. Once again, Mr. Visitor Chancellor, I congratulate the graduates, their parents, and relations. I wish you success in all that you do for your own good and the good of this country. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Governing Council, I thank you profusely for being with us today. I wish you all safe journey back to your respective destinations. I thank you.
You just heard an address by the Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of Governing Council, Federal University of Technology, Mina, Professor Olu Obafemi. He started out his address by issuing his condolences to the university over the death of his
Chancellor, sir.
Professor Femi
Odeh. I have the honor to call.
Next up is the Vice Chancellor of the university. He's expected to mount the podium to give his address.
SL to deliver his address to the convocation. Vice Chancellor, sir.
Live from the Suleiman Kumo Convocation Square, main campus of FUT MINA, this is the outside broadcast of Surge 92.3.
Live from the Suleiman Kumo Convocation Square,
the
campus
visitor to the university, President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, ably represented here today by the Honorable Minister of State for Education, Chief Emeka Wajoba, the Executive Governor of Niger State, ably represented by the Commissioner Tertiary Education, Professor Babali, the Deputy Governor of Ondo State, members of the National Assembly here, the Chancellor of the University, the Deji, and Paramount Ruler of Akure Kingdom and his Oloris, the Pro-Chancellor, the Ashiwaju of Kiri Kingdom and his Olori, members of council, visiting vice chancellors and heads of other institutions, former vice chancellors of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, principal officers of the university, my wives and better halves, members of Senate, members of congregation, our distinguished guests here present, the graduates, great Nigerian students, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen. Minister, sir, I have a rather lengthy speech, so permit me to read the abridged version of the speech. Details are found in the speech booklet. It is with profound pleasure that I welcome you to the first of 2 days, marking the 38th Founders Day celebrations and the 38th convocation ceremonies of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. The university is highly honored by the presence of such eminent personalities as are seated here this morning, and we thank you for your presence. The convocation this year is unique in many respects. It is the first we are holding since the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic, and this necessitates the need for us to take additional health and safety measures. Secondly, it is the first convocation since the passing away of our former pro-chancellor, the late Professor Femi Odekunle, and a former vice-chancellor, Professor Muhammad Abdullahi Daniel. As painful as these losses are, we are consoled by the fact that both men lived exemplary and impactful lives worthy of emulation. May their souls rest in peace, and may their family members, loved ones, and associates continue to derive comfort from the legacies of their lives and the fortitude to bear the losses. Thirdly, today's convocation has ushered in a new chancellor of the university, His Imperial Majesty Alade Toyinbo Ogunlade Adelusi Odundun II, Deji and paramount ruler of Akure Kingdom, who was installed earlier this morning by the visitor of the university. It is also the first convocation since the reconstitution of the university governing councils by the president and commander-in-chief, President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR. The chairman of council and pro-chancellor, Professor Olu Obafemi, the Ashuaju of Kiri Kingdom, is a cerebral and a highly respected academic and a recipient of the highly prestigious Nigerian National Order of Merit. The university is already richly harvesting from his experience, wide network, and wise counsel of this eminent Nigerian and his colleagues. We also have, since the last convocation, a crop of new principal officers in the persons of Professor Farouk Adamukuta, the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic, Mrs. Hadiza Goje, the Bursar, and Dr. Katemba Abubakar Saka, the University Librarian. The other unique thing about this convocation is that, unlike previous years, today's event is dedicated largely to the award of first degrees and prizes. The award of higher degrees and diplomas comes up tomorrow. Finally, and on a personal note, this will be my last convocation as the Vice Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology, MENA, as my tenure will lapse before the next convocation. Therefore, I consider today's event as an opportunity for me to share a few of our experiences in over 4 years in office. The visitor, sir, ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to stand before you and to observe that the Federal University of Technology, MENA, is in a sound and better shape than it was when I assumed office 4 years ago. In line with the vision of the university, FUT MENA has continued to be a leading Nigerian university, recognized for excellence, and has consistently been ranked among the top 10 Nigerian and top 100 African universities, irrespective of ranking, institution, or sets of criteria. Our students and alumni continue to excel and are world beaters anywhere they are found. We were able to make this progress as a result of the reforms and numerous measures taken to enthrone the requisite enabling environment and global best practices. To promote sound academic culture and avoid the arbitrariness and uncertainties that characterize the absence of clear rules, a number of policy reforms were introduced, resulting in the development and launching of five new policies, including those on student support services, anti-sexual harassment, and intellectual property. Additional policies that have been developed or reviewed include those on research, information and communication technology, environmental hazard, health and safety, research ethics and integrity, anti-corruption and whistleblowing, and persons with disabilities. We have kept our promise to establish the procurement office, the student support services unit, the intellectual property and technology transfer office, and the health and safety office. The university in the last 4 years signed 32 agreements and memoranda of understandings for partnerships with institutions and industry partners. This volume is unprecedented in our history, and the agreements cover a diverse range of engagements, including research and development, faculty exchange, public-private partnerships, affiliations for undergraduate and postgraduate programs, and students' internships and entrepreneurship training. In our desire to provide education that is globally competitive, responsive, and consonant with government policies on economic diversification and local content, the university has established 10 new undergraduate degree programs, including those for mining engineering, petroleum and gas engineering, and information technology. To ensure good quality teaching and curriculum delivery, the university has, in the past 4 years, sponsored 225 academic staff for study fellowship, including 144 PhD fellowships. And the university today has about 60% of all its faculty members possessing PhD degrees. The oversight functions of statutory units, such as the Directorate of Quality Assurance and Productivity, Servicom, are being complemented by that of the Quality Teaching Monitoring Committee, established under the leadership of a former Deputy Vice Chancellor to ensure that lectures are delivered as and when due. 42 of the university's 44 undergraduate programs have full accreditation by the National Universities Commission, while all professional programs have full accreditation from their respective professional bodies. We have procured and deployed more resources for teaching and learning. Our subscriptions to quality research databases and the development and deployment of digital library management software have swelled the e-library users to over 21,000. Students' academic processes, starting from registration to examination resource management, are fully automated. And parents and guardians are able to monitor the academic progress of their children and wards from the comfort of their homes or anywhere else in the world. The university is improving access to university education through its open and distance learning program, which is one of only 11 licensed by the NUC. The number of institutions running degree affiliation programs with the university has also more than doubled in the past 4 years. The university has demonstrated in the past 4 years how students are at the core of our decisions and policies. We have developed a student support services policy to enhance students' experiences on our campuses and establish a unit led by a former registrar to coordinate implementation. The 2021 ranking of Nigerian public universities by NUC places FUT Minna first in the retention and graduation of students with an efficiency of 97.57%. The university has entered into agreements with some industry partners to provide internship and similar placements for our students. Through the university's International Test Center, ICT Academies and Entrepreneurship Center, we are providing a variety of specialized trainings and certifications for our students so as to enhance their employability and prepare them for life after the university. We have also instituted the Vice Chancellor Students Awards Ceremony since 2020 to recognize students with outstanding academic performance and students who have won laurels for the university in various areas of academic and extracurricular activities. Over 900 students have so far received certificates of recognition, cash prizes, and scholarships since the introduction of the award. The university has launched the Students' Benevolence Fund, which is an initiative at providing financial support to indigent students so that no student of the university will drop out of school on account of financial difficulties. Sports is a critical component that complements the three domains of learning. Hence, requisite support and facilities for sports are provided by the university to enable our students keep fit, imbibe the culture of sportsmanship, and build their confidence and team spirit. The Federal University of Technology, MENA, has since 2014 ensured that graduates collect their certificates on the day of convocation. And this is not going to be different this year. We have also introduced reforms in the processing and issuance of transcripts such that graduates are now able to receive their transcripts within 2 hours of request. And starting from this convocation, not only are graduates able to collect their certificates, but they can also collect the students' copies of their transcripts on request. The 2018 Nigerian Graduate Report ranked the Federal University of Technology, MENA, as the fourth most preferable by employers of labor with an employability index of 60.61%. The university has met the reward and retention of well-trained and motivated workforce a priority. We staff earning promotion as and when due. Between 2018 and 2021, a total of 1,216 staff were promoted, including 87 professors. The university also awarded study fellowships to 308 staff and sponsored 419 for attendance of conferences and workshops. The university has, in 4 years, organized more than 30 in-house trainings for its staff in administration, ICT, exam management, entrepreneurship, and business development. Staff fitness and well-being are also encouraged through an array of sporting activities, through weekly aerobics and monthly Work for Life programs. The committee system is a veritable and time-tested governance tool in the university, which we have readily deployed to multiply the opportunities for students, for staff and students' inclusion in university governance and decision-making. To this end, 5 retreats and over 125 committees have been constituted since 2018. We expanded the scope and categories of the ServiceCom Awards so that more persons now receive the awards. 29 staff were awarded by ServiceCom in 2019, and about 40 others are set to receive the award in February this year. We initiated the Vice Chancellor's Commendation Awards, and its maiden edition in 2021, we had 164 staff and student awardees that were recognized for distinguishing themselves in the 7 categories of academic excellence. I'm proud to observe the warm and cordial relationships that exist among the various unions in the university and between the unions and management. These have engendered a peaceful and conducive environment for learning and for work. No wonder FUT MENA continues to serve as a standard bearer for campus peace and progress. I wish to thank our staff and students' unions for little would have been achieved without their support and cooperation. We continue to have a robust engagement with our host community through a variety of interventions, including meetings, sports, agricultural extension, capacity building on ICT, entrepreneurship, and skill acquisition programs, as well as infrastructural interventions in education, power, water, healthcare, security, and cultural facilities. Funding by the Tertiary Education Transport TED Fund and the NIS Assessment Fund for the Revitalization of Public Universities has enabled us to start and complete more than 30 projects, 23 of which have been commissioned this week, and which will allow for the relocation to the Gideon Kwano campus, the schools of life sciences, physical sciences, and the postgraduate school. A number of ministries, departments, and agencies have also helped in the provision of infrastructure and equipment to the university. We appreciate the support from the Nigerian Communications Commission, the National Information Technology Development Agency, the Nigerian Meteorological Agency, National Office for Technology Acquisition and Promotion, National Intelligence Agency, and the Federal Ministry of Works and Housing. The university is through public-private partnership arrangements also making provisions for additional infrastructure, including students' hostels, a hotel, and varied business ventures. Using funds from internally generated revenue has also enabled the university to carry out major renovation projects and provide critical infrastructure, including 10 water supply projects, 5 projects under transportation, 6 projects under roads, walkways and signages, 4 under health and safety, and 2 under radio and television. Graduation statistics. The visitors, ladies and gentlemen, by the authority of the University Senate, we shall be awarding first degrees to a total of 3,892 deserving undergraduate students of the 2019-2020 academic session at this convocation. This includes 329 students from our affiliate institutions, made up of 116 from Kaduna Polytechnic and 213 from Federal College of Education Technical Potiskum. Of the 3,892 graduates, 58 are graduating with first class. 948 with second class upper division. 2,047 with second class lower division. Let my people go. 801 with third class and 38 with past degrees. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the pleasure of announcing Enebe Simon Adinoyi of the Department of Quantity Survey, School of Environmental Technology, as the overall best graduating student of the university for the 2019-2020 academic session. He is graduating with a CGPA of 4.88, first class. In line with the university's recent transition, the certificates of our graduates are ready for collection immediately, the convocation closes. And as I said earlier, henceforth, graduates will, in addition, be able to collect students' copies of their transcripts on request. I heartily congratulate our graduates and their parents on this occasion. We wish them the best of the future ahead. We believe that the knowledge, experience, and contacts they have garnered here at the Federal University of Technology, MENA, will equip and strengthen them to confront the challenges of life and contribute positively to the society. This graduation is not the end of your journey with FUT MENA. Your connection to the university community is lifelong. We expect to see you often as valuable members of our alumni community. In the last 4 years, I have had the pleasure of working with so many people within and outside the university. Without their cooperation, support, goodwill, and prayers, little progress would have been made. Given that they are too numerous to mention individually, I would rather wish to thank all our stakeholders, government, foreign partners, ministries, departments, agencies, non-governmental organizations, venture partners and donors, the host community, opinion leaders, members of council, senate, staff, alumni, and students with whom we have been working together for the good of this university and our nation. Finally, I would like to thank and appreciate the tireless efforts of members of the University Ceremonies Committee, ably led by the Deputy Vice Chancellor Administration, Professor E.E. Udensi, in ensuring a successful convocation. I thank you all for your kind attention. Thank you.
And that, of course, was a speech by the Vice Chancellor of the Federal University of Technology and the person of Professor Abdullahi Bala. It was a very detailed speech. And of course, we will have the award of first degrees coming up next. And now we will have students from his department, from his school rather, in the person of Professor G.N. Madu.
Absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Agriculture of the Federal University of Technology. Please, would the graduate remove their cap?
by the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor of Architectural Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Live from the Suleiman Kumo Convocation Square, main campus of FUT MENA, this is the outside broadcast of Surge 92.3.
Congratulations.
And we have students, or rather, I should say graduates now.
The Dean from the School of Electrical Engineering and Technology.
Just graduated now by the Chancellor. And up next is the Dean of the School of Electrical Engineering and Technology in the person of Engineer Professor E.N.
With the students of the School of Electrical Engineering and Technology.
Graduating students from the School of Electrical Engineering and Technology.
Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Engineering examinations and are found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Engineering of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Graduates, please remove your hats.
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor of Engineering of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Graduates, please raise up your caps. Wear them and flip the tassels to the left. Congratulations. You may now be seated.
And that is the second school of graduates, the School of Electrical
Engineering
and
School
Technology.
Of Environmental
and up next
Technology.
Is the School of Environmental Technology to be presented by their Dean, Professor R.E. Olagunju. This is the third school of graduates that will be presented to the Chancellor for graduation today.
With the graduating students in the School of Environmental Technology, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. By the authority
from
of Senate,
Kumo Convocation Square, main campus of FUT MENA, this is the outside broadcast of Surge FM 92.3.
Technology MENA, congratulations.
The graduates, please raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassel on the cap
I'll be called to the left. Please be seated. Thank you.
And that was the Dean School.
The Dean School of Information.
Now we move to the School of Information and Communication Technology, and the acting Dean, Professor Nicholas S., will be presenting the student.
We, the graduating students in the School of Information and Communication Technology, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proud, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Graduates, will you remove your caps?
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Graduates. Graduates, raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassels of the caps to the left. Please be seated.
Professor Nicholas has presented for the School of Information and Communication Technology.
School of Infrastructure, Process Engineering and Technology.
And this will be done by Engineer Professor Z.D. Osunde.
But I need them to talk to that one with the podium first.
Is the one they are using now?
Okay, the one they are using
for now.
Will the graduating students?
No.
And in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Engineering of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Please, the graduates, remove their caps.
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor of Engineering of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Graduates, please raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassel of the caps to the left. Please be seated.
That is the School of Infrastructure, Process Engineering and Technology. That is being done by Engineer Professor Z.D.
Osunde. School of
now
Innovative Technology.
To be done by Professor E.O. Oni. He is the Acting Dean, School of Innovative Technology, SIT.
Graduating student in the School of Innovative Technology, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. The graduates, remove your cap.
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor's of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Please raise your cap up, wear them, and place the tassel of the cap to the left. You may be seated.
That was the Dean, School of Innovative Technology, awarding the degree of Bachelor of Technology
School of
to the
Life Sciences.
And next will be the Dean, School of Life Sciences, in the person of Professor F.O. Arimoro, to confer the degree of Bachelor of Technology to the students of the School of Life Sciences.
The School of Life Sciences, please stand. Honorable Chancellor, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded a degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. The graduates, will you remove your cap?
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor's of Technology of Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Graduates, you are requested to raise your caps, wear them, place the tassel of the cap to the left. Congratulations, please be seated.
That was the Dean School of Life Sciences.
The Dean School of Fiscal Sciences.
Bachelor of Technology to the graduates. And next will be the Dean School of Physical Sciences in the person of Professor J. Yisa. He will be awarding the degree of Bachelor of Technology to the graduates or students of the School of
Physical
Sciences.
Will the graduating student in the School of Physical Sciences please stand? Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present a graduate standing before you and those who are unavoidably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examinations and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. The graduates, please remove your caps.
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor's of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Graduates, raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassels of the caps to the left. Congratulations, and be seated.
That was the Dean of School of Physical Sciences who just presented the students
the Dean,
to the Chancellor,
School of Science
awarding
and
them with
Technology
the degree of Bachelor
Education.
Of Technology. And right next is the Dean School of Science and Technology Education in the person of Professor A.I. Gumbery. He will be presenting the graduate
student in the School of Science and Technology Education. Please stand. Honorable Chancellor, sir, I present the graduates standing before you and those who are unaffordably absent, for whom I stand proxy, and who have successfully completed their Bachelor of Technology examination and have been found worthy, both in character and in learning, to be awarded the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Graduates, please remove your caps.
By the authority of Senate, I award you all and severally the degree of Bachelor of Technology of the Federal University of Technology, MENA. Congratulations.
Graduates, raise your caps, wear them, and place the tassel of the caps to the left. Congratulations. Please be seated.
And with that, all of the 9 schools from the Federal University of Technology have had their total of 3,892
Chancellor, students. Chancellor, sir, I have the honor to present to you the following and those who, for good reasons, are unavailably absent and for whom I stand proxy, who have distinguished themselves by winning special prizes in their respective fields of